You're watching the latest news from financialmirror.tv. Profits evaporated at leading banks on Monday, and authorities worldwide pressed on with efforts to temper a recession that policymakers said had become reality for much of the globe. The European Commission said the 15-nation eurozone was in a technical recession and economic growth would come to a virtual standstill next year. Societe Generale reported an 8.4% drop in third quarter net profit, down to €183 million, with losses from the collapse of Lehman Brothers and other write-downs costing it €1.2 billion in pre-tax income. Germany's Commerzbank said it would take €23 billion of state investment, having posted a third quarter loss of €285 million. Britain's biggest home lender, HBOS, raised its hit from the value of risky assets and bad loans to over £5 billion as its takeover partner, Lloyds TSB, predicted a sharp fall in profits. Interbank lending rates fell, extending last week's decline, reflecting ongoing central bank efforts to add liquidity rather than banks lending to each other. Banks deposited a record €280 billion with the European Central Bank on Monday rather than making it available to peers. Berlin aims to safeguard 1 million jobs with pump priming measures to be agreed in cabinet on Wednesday by spending more than €30 billion. Eurozone finance ministers are meeting in Brussels to discuss reform of institutions that manage the global financial market and bodies such as credit rating agencies, account rule setters, banks and their management. And finance chiefs from the Group of 20 gather in Brazil later this week to prepare for a US-hosted November 15 summit of world leaders to chart a way out of the crisis. The eurozone is already in a technical recession and growth will come to a virtual standstill next year, the European Commission said on Monday, calling for coordinated EU action to support growth. Economic and Monetary Affairs Commissioner Joaquin Almunia said coordinated action is needed at EU level to support the economy, similar to what was done for the financial sector. Economic growth in the 15 countries using the euro will slow to 0.1% next year from 1.2% expected this year. The Commission forecasts 0.9% growth for 2010. The slowdown will boost unemployment to 8.4% of the workforce next year from 7.6% seen this year and further increase to 8.7% in 2010. The Commission expects that the Eurozone's three biggest economies, Germany, France and Italy, will not grow at all next year, while the economies of Ireland and Spain will contract. The Eurozone outlook is still better than that of the United States, where the economy is set to shrink 0.5% next year. The Commission expects Japan to contract 0.4% in 2009. The European Central Bank wants to keep inflation below, but close to, 2%. But consumer price growth was boosted by surging oil and food prices in the 12 months to mid-2008. The bank has signalled it may cut interest rates in November as inflation risks have diminished. The United States must continue to spearhead efforts to overcome the global financial crisis, according to Britain's Prime Minister Gordon Brown, speaking a day before the world's biggest economy votes for a new president. The economic upheaval has relegated Tuesday's US presidential election to little more than a footnote for financial markets. Investors have factored in a victory for Democrat Barack Obama, who leads in opinion polls. Brown said world trade was slowing more than expected and said richer states who are willing to give money to the IMF to help vulnerable economies through the credit crisis should have a greater say in how it's run. Washington is due to host a global summit on November the 15th, by which time either Obama or Republican John McCain will have been elected the next US president. That meeting has been billed as a chance to reform international institutions and to build a consensus on how to shore up the financial system and prevent a severe downturn. Brown has also called on the world's largest oil exporter, Saudi Arabia, China, and other relatively wealthy states to help raise hundreds of billions of dollars for a new IMF facility to stabilize struggling economies. Brown has proposed a five-pillar plan for the November 15th meeting: stronger banks and more lending, restoring confidence in the financial system, better coordination of fiscal and monetary policy, more cash for the IMF, and free trade. OPEC members might have ignored output limits in the past, but they mean business now after oil prices shed more than half their value in 3 months and financial turmoil has crushed demand. Most of the 11 members of the oil producers cartel, which set targets, have said they were reducing output in line with a deal last month to take away 5%. After the agreement at an emergency meeting, oil prices sank below $62 a barrel, but have since recovered slightly. Top exporter Saudi Arabia has yet to tell customers its intentions, but industry sources said it was about to do so. Iran is the next biggest OPEC exporter, and it has told customers they will receive less oil. Even Nigeria, which has been forced by militant attacks to rein in production and is pumping below agreed limits, has said it will lower output in November and December by 5%. Already in September, OPEC had promised to remove around 500,000 barrels per day of surplus production above its limits. September shipments fell by around 300,000 barrels per day and dropped again in October. In the near term, market sentiment could still stay negative whatever OPEC does, as lost confidence and limited credit to buy oil drives demand and prices down further. Irish airline Ryanair posted a 31% fall in second quarter profit on Monday, but said it was still confident of breaking even in the full year and rebounding next year if oil prices stay low. Europe's biggest low-cost airline said net profit for the 3 months to the end of September came in at €185.78 million after exceptional losses. That compared with €190 million expected by four analysts surveyed by Reuters. Scrapping recent warnings of a possible full-year loss after the price of oil fell by half since June, Ryanair affirmed the strategy of cutting fares aggressively and growing capacity to snatch business from struggling rivals across Europe. Ryanair plans to add 33 new aircraft in the next 6 to 7 months, helping it to carry 67 to 68 million passengers next year and taking the airline to second place behind Air France KLM. Ryanair expects to generate 15 to 20% lower fares and to make a loss in the second half of this fiscal year, including the seasonally weak winter period, which is expected to add to the already long list of casualties among airlines. Earnings will rebound strongly next year if oil stays around $80 per barrel, according to Chief Executive Mike O'Leary. Thank you for watching FinancialMirror.tv.